BreakFace.
All right. Welcome, everybody, to BreakFace, Alaska's own first real podcast ever.
Yeah, well, homegrown.
Yeah, I mean, there's other ones
We're
here.
We're all born and raised
but
here.
But they suck. Ours is awesome. I'm Poi Poi. That's Titty. And in the studio tonight, we have two very special guests. First, Sarah from AFC. Owner, right?
Yep.
And
Una. Matchmaker, everything. She runs the entire show.
Okay, yeah, you eat that mic. And this is Tommy Ide, also known as the Potbelly Assassin. And he is looking slim as shit.
I know.
Look at him. Look awesome.
I got to show you. I got a poster photo here. Hold on a second.
Oh, my gosh.
I saw some
Can
comments.
Can he take his shirt off while he...
I saw some comments
I'm not
that said,
scared.
What if you lose your potbelly? Are they still
oh
going to call
gosh.
You potbelly?
He looks completely different.
Oh, my God, yeah.
You can't even see my shoulders in that one.
So what do you...
This one round ball.
Yeah, you're going to change your name now?
No, man. I'll keep my name forever, man, because I know where I came from and what I've gone through to be here. And you also never know who you're inspiring.
For sure.
That's why I'll keep the name all the way down to 155 pounds.
So you're nice. Going to do a before and after photo and inspire the children to lose weight.
Inspire anybody.
You're going to inspire. Adult, you're inspiring me, dude.
I was going to say inspire me. Yeah, exactly.
I need some inspiration.
I lost 30 pounds in the last like 6 weeks.
Wow.
What's your diet? And what are you doing? Just eating greens?
I eat like bacon and eggs in the morning and stuffed steak with like prosciutto and
okay, so you look great, but your arteries are going.
What's prosciutto?
Yeah. It is like a marbled meat. It's delicious.
Isn't it prosciutto?
Prosciutto.
Thanks, sir.
He's a great firefighter, but Mimi, no speaky, no well.
My husband's Italian, okay? I know. We have plenty of prosciutto at the house.
Dude, that's awesome. I want to like.
I don't even care. It's delicious.
Hey, he don't care. He's stuffing it in his steak. You don't give a shit. Leave him alone.
Made a meat shake? Have you ever done that?
Oh, no. Please don't.
I got some. No, I'm not. Yeah. I'm not talking about that kind of meat shake.
No. I know what you're talking about. A blender with meat in it.
Well, okay.
You're sick.
Oh, well.
One time, sick. A fighter did that. Actually, it was a guy broke his jaw, and I happened to be in the hospital the same day, and all he wanted was a hamburger, and so his wife went and blended it up, and he drank it through a straw.
Yep.
Did you enjoy it?
I didn't ask him.
Would you do that? Oh, my jaw's broken. I really want a hamburger.
My brother John broke his jaw one time, and he got blended roast beef.
I did.
I tasted it.
I might take some blended pizza or something.
I did.
That sounds more my speed.
I juiced for like 3 weeks or something like that because I have some kind of weird throat issue and I like my esophagus was bleeding and I was choking on everything.
Yeah, he has a weird throat issue.
Yeah,
it's called. I don't
know. So I had Larry Jack. So,
oh yeah, I forgot to assess your level of comfort before we started the show.
Yeah.
My bad.
So we are not gentlemen at all.
You'll see how my face gets, and you can judge on that based on that.
Not if you're wearing foundation. I know how that works. Oh, I know why this isn't working. Okay, so what was I saying? Oh,
juicing.
Anyways, yeah, juicing. So I like had to blend up a whole roast and get my protein that way. I couldn't stand it anymore. You can only take so much beet juice and. Or whatever.
Yeah,
else.
I did that. The juicing diet for 8 days, and I was like hallucinating and sniffing Lucky Charms. So I'm good. I'll never do that again.
Dude, that's awesome. I want. I have so many questions for you. One is like, well, no, from how you AFC started, what your role was in the beginning, all the way to your potbelly pig. Do you have a potbelly pig or just regular pig?
I have two mini pigs.
Oh my God, they're not potbelly. They're mini.
Well, they're.
Oh
they're
my God, my daughter would love you.
Yeah, they're
my
considered pot bellies, but they're like Julian pigs, and the other ones, like, we don't know. We adopted it, we rescued it, so we don't know exactly what it is. So,
how do you adopt and rescue a pig? Was someone abusing it and doing pig fighting?
I really, really think that the pig was abused. Seriously.
Really?
Yeah, because when we first got her, she was really skittish. Her name's Cheeto, and she's a little red ginger pig.
Ginger
She's a ginger pig. But the girl who rescued her, the kid named her, but yeah, do you want to talk about the pigs later, or you want to talk about
it? Doesn't matter. This is open forum, but we can start off with what the hell. It was like, how long have you been going? Forever.
So AFC has been around for 14 years, and
God,
I have been running it
awesome,
for
dude.
10 years. This is my this will be my 10th year anniversary.
You can't stop the train.
It was started by your father?
No. See, and that's it's so funny, the confusion.
See, that's
everyone,
what I thought too.
Everyone thinks like, oh, that's a daddy's thing. And no, me and my dad actually went partners in on it. So what had happened was I was a mortgage broker and was looking for creative ways to advertise. And my dad saw a guy out on the side of the road holding a sign saying fights tonight. And him and I used to, I would ride my bike down to Video City and rent the UFCs. And but him,
was it you?
no. And I'd have my little basket and take them back, and me and dad would watch the UFC. And so, I mean, I was probably 9, 10, 11, sometime in there when I first started watching them. And so it's always kind of been a bond that we've had. And so he goes, hey, Sarah, somebody's holding a sign on the side of the road that says MMA fights tonight. You want to go? And I was like, sure. So we like bought the cheap seats and set up in the stands. And it was AFC number 8. And it's when Brian Ryan knocked out Clyde Jenkins in 6 seconds.
Whoa, cool.
So that happened. And I'm like, oh, my goodness. I flipped over the program. I got the guy's number on the back. I called him right then. And I said, hey, I want to advertise on a table. So for the next 2.5-3 years, I started advertising with my business. And it really worked because I was younger. I was only like 22. 23 in the mortgage business, and it's kind of hard to get business that young. So I was hitting
because no one takes you seriously.
Yeah, they were like,
get out of here, kid.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, I mean, I really, my business just kind of went crazy after that. I was doing the fighters loans and the sponsors loans, and it was awesome. And so I kind of just got immersed in the fight community that way, met everybody. And the owners at the time asked if I was interested in purchasing it. They're trying to sell it, trying to get out from underneath it. And I found out later why, but at the time I'm like, oh yeah, this is awesome. Let's do this. Like, running my own business wasn't enough. I had to get another one. So my dad and I had invested in some real estate, and we had sold a piece of property that we had, and we went in joint venture. Like, my mom, it's my mom and dad. I mean, it's, you know, one and the same.
Sure.
It was their money and my money, and we bought it. And about a year and a half later, I decided that I wasn't happy doing what I was doing, and the AFC wasn't making any money, and I had almost everything I owned into the AFC. It's either go and invest the time into what it needed.
Balls deep.
And I quit my job. And
balls deep, he said.
Took me 3.5, almost 4 years to make any sort of money. So it was year five that I actually was in the green. So I put every penny I had into it to continue on. And it gave me the opportunity also to spend more time with my kid, because I was single mom at the time. I didn't meet my husband until my daughter was 6, turning 7.
Wow, cool.
So I, you know, commuting back and forth from Anchorage, and she was in school in Wasilla, and it was really tough. So I decided I was going to go have a flexible schedule and go for it. So I didn't know what I was doing. I mean, I had no idea. Matchmaking, like, people didn't take me seriously as a woman. They're like, what does this girl know about fights? Which I knew about fights, but I didn't know about matchmaking. I didn't know about running my own business.
Right.
I mean, in that sense.
I'm sure that's you picked it up. You learned it along the way.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. It's not something that you can go to college for. I mean, being a matchmaker.
How to run a fighting business?
Yeah. It's like.
Why not?
No. And that's the that's the problem. I was right off the bat, I was paying somebody to do the matchmaking, and it was just absolutely terrible. And, you know, I was like, I got to take control of this, because a lot gets lost in translation. So, I mean, if the fighters talk directly to me, they know who they're dealing with, and they know that what I say is going to happen.
So
and
you're still really involved in that process right now, then?
100%. I'm actually the only technically the only employee of AFC. We work a lot off of volunteers, and we also work like contract employees. So, like, the fighters are contract employees, and DJs, announcers, stuff like that. So I'm technically the only employee. I do all the marketing, all the bookkeeping.
Wow.
Isn't
a produce your own schedule type of thing no more, is it? It's your, I mean.
Oh, no, I still get to do my schedule, and that's, things have to be done.
Yeah.
You can't just sit around, and when they do need to be done, they need to be done quickly.
That's why most businesses fail, because people get in their own thing, and they're like, I don't have a boss, I can do whatever the hell I want to do. And
right, then, you have to work.
But yeah, you don't realize how much work goes into it.
Because now you'll
get AFC.
Now
it's you. It's your
face,
your ass. And
you wouldn't even know. I wouldn't even have known that you would have started off with those struggles. It just looks, I don't know. Because I didn't get into it until after, I don't know, probably 2 years after you had taken over.
Right.
And so, I mean, I don't know. It's awesome. It's
Thank you.
A great event to go to. We go.
I have a blast.
So what year did you take over?
It was it would have been 10 years. So I guess it would have been 2006.
2006?
2006, 2007. Yeah, right.
So you took over right when I was actually volunteering. Because that's when I first started volunteering, was around 2006.
Yeah, yeah. And that's probably why I didn't.
We were in it together.
Yeah, we were.
From the ground.
Well, and you know, Ernie, I accumulated, you know, some people that were already knew what they were doing. So if it wasn't for those people, I would have been so lost, because they're kind of holding my hand, taking me around and showing me the ropes. I mean, I didn't know what I was doing at all. And
you mentioned Ernie. I miss that dude.
I do too.
I really like that guy.
Ernie's awesome, and his family's awesome. And Corinne and Sabrina, they would come a big part of the fights when they moved. I was pretty bummed. So.
Where did they move to?
I think California. Yeah. Cause something, I think his mom was sick. And so
that's too bad. If you ever see this, Ernie, I miss you, buddy.
Yeah, I'm gonna send it to Ernie. We miss him.
Oh, dude, awesome. Nice.
Yeah, he's awesome. So yeah, we have a lot of people who have been there since day one, like Kevin Avalar. You know, he's our Joe Rogan. He's our commentator. And
okay, he's the ring announcer.
Yeah,
that
Pino
dude is amazing.
Pino,
he is so cool.
Oh, Kevin, I think, is one of the best in business. We always joke about his accent and stuff. You know, he's like Budweiser, the king of beers.
Yeah.
You know? So we love Kevin. I mean, he's awesome. And Pino, I mean, he's been a long time ref. He actually fought in like one of the first AFCs. I don't know if you knew that or not. But
so did Jeremy Horn and Rich Franklin.
Yeah, Jeremy Horn and Rich Franklin fought on the first fight card, AFC 1. I missed it because I wasn't involved. You know, I wasn't going yet. But as for like people that are involved, you know, with the AFC, the volunteers and the judges, I mean, they've just, everybody stuck around, and it's so awesome because it's like, you know, it's a big family.
Dude, that's crazy. I didn't realize that was that many. Boy, I can't even effing talk. I don't know why, but that many volunteers. I figured everybody was on some kind of a payroll, or
we wouldn't make it.
I was wondering.
Yeah,
about
I knew that it was a strong volunteer presence when I was, because I was volunteering. My payment was I got into the fight.
Yep. So with the Sullivan, are those all those people there? Those are part of the payment for the Sullivan?
We contract out the like the security, the ticket takers, all of that. But any AFC staff that you see, AFC staff, majority they work on volunteering, which we do. We barter, you know.
Yeah,
get you know free different things or you know, like our cage girls. They are completely taken care of. They get all their tanning, their lashes. They get their hair done.
You might as well just pay them for a fight. Then
I didn't get tanning or lashes.
I mean, just give them $20 a fight. I'm pretty sure they'd do it.
Oh, right? Absolutely.
$20 and a Coors Light.
Yeah, what? Yeah. They no.
What do you think?
And some broccoli. Some broccoli.
But
stuff steak.
They know they get the pizza at the after fight party, and I guarantee you they eat their fair share of pizza. Yeah.
So are they on some kind of weight schedule? Can I talk about that?
No, they don't. I mean, they're, you know what,
if one comes in and she just doesn't measure up quite, you're like,
you're
out. Sorry, Kathy. Your measurements, baby. Your muffin top isn't working.
They're the ones that are going to have to face the crowd. You don't see me up there and getting in a bikini. There's a reason.
Can I do it?
I don't care.
You want to be a ring girl?
I'll be a ring girl.
That doesn't shock me.
Shoot, yeah.
Actually,
free pizza afterwards?
You know what? It's Bob's birthday bash on this next upcoming fight card, so maybe you could give him a little lap dance or something.
I'm fine with that. I'm totally down with that.
Blindfold him.
Did you ever hear about the Alice incident from Caleb?
No.
So about 5-6 years ago, we had Bob's birthday bash, and this is probably as about dirty as you'll ever hear me talk. So enjoy it.
It's recorded.
So he
it's forever.
Bob didn't know what was going on, and I believe he was blindfolded, but he was sitting in the middle of the cage, and they were getting Porno Brad was getting Alice just liquored up bad. I mean, just hammered. And so Alice comes out strutting down the thing like a Chris Farley lookalike, and he like rips his pants off, and he's in like this like bikini bottoms. And Alice is a very large man.
He's a big dude.
Yeah, he's
so
pretty big.
He used to be even
bigger.
Yeah, yeah,
he was so huge. He was, I think Bob got the blindfold off, and he's dancing on Bob, and I thought there was a fake pair of something hanging out of his underwear.
Testicles.
Oh, yeah. No.
They were for real.
But they were real.
Oh.
And I didn't realize it. And they were almost to his knees. And
oh, no. You're fit. No.
I didn't know.
He's got them pendulum nuts.
I did not. I can't even believe I'm telling the story.
This is great.
So I thought it was fake until I saw the photographs afterwards. They get uploaded to our website. And everyone's like, "Oh, did you see that?" You know, and I'm like, "No, I was trying not to look because it was like pink panties. Like he had some tight pink panties on."
A thong.
And no, it wasn't a thong. It was.
I can't. Even imagine
maybe it was because it was a. You know, he was large, but it wasn't his fault.
His ass just ate the...
Yeah, he just disappeared. Just ate the pants. What do you mean? I'm wearing a full... Boxer briefs. What are you talking about?
So then I see the photos, and I had to delete the photos that were on the website.
How'd you find out they were real? He told you? Or
I saw the photos afterwards.
And just,
it was kind of hard to tell?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. At least you didn't go up there and go, ha-ha.
No, I ran. I
those are funny.
I didn't.
She's all, oh. Yeah.
No, I don't allow anything like that. When I've actually bought the fights, I made the Cage Girls completely change their outfits. Like, I run a family show. Like, I want my 8-year-old, when my daughter was 8,
not
I
on
wanted
the drinking
her.
Side. People are like, what?
Oh, yeah, yeah. But I mean, I'm talking about
that's
what
why they're
we,
separated.
Yeah. And what we control. Yeah, yeah, the music, sure. You'll never hear an F bomb. You'll never hear
right on.
The N word. And, it, you know, there's time, place for that. And it's not at the fights.
No, that's here.
And that's actually why I didn't want to be a fighter, because they wouldn't approve my fight music.
Oh, they probably wouldn't have.
I'm just kidding.
I actually go, just kidding. I go through an
NWA.
Straight out of Compton, you crazy motherfucking.
Yeah, we don't allow, and so if cube. your cornermen cuss, if they cuss, it's $50. I say $50 a fuck. That's
wow.
Are you serious?
Do you hold them to that?
I will. If it becomes out of control.
So
I mean,
what happened? There was quite a few fights ago when I can't even remember who it was, but I was sitting on the side and one of the
through water.
I don't know. It was one of the fighters. Coaches and this other dude, he went up and hit him or whatever, and there's like this little fight going down next to the ring.
Yeah, they get fined. I mean, that's I've had guys that I mean, I had a fighter one time who actually was at a fight and I mean got beat up quick within a few seconds, and then it was actually a woman decided to go and jump somebody in the parking lot.
What?
And I saw the whole thing. I'm like over there eating.
Wow, she was pissed, huh?
Yeah, well,
save
apparently
that rage
it was,
for the cage,
it was her ex-boyfriend, so. She goes over and
then it's okay.
That makes sense.
Yeah. It was incredible. And she kept calling me for payment and for her getting paid that.
And
I'm
you
like,
said no.
I'm like, no, you were fined. And I called the cops and had you arrested. You were fined your whole fight purse and you will never be welcome back in AFC again.
Whoa,
I mean,
that's cool.
We wow. don't ever, you know, I don't put up with it. I don't put up
with
it.
Well, you can't. You can't. There's too much liability.
Right.
So, yeah.
Right. No, I don't blame you. Absolutely. So, we want to keep it a clean show. And, you know, I don't want parents grabbing their kids' ears and covering them up and saying, oh, this music isn't appropriate
no
or whatever.
No F-bombs, though. I mean, come on.
People are like, oh, they're going there to watching people get the shit beat out of them.
Why can't they?
It's a sport.
No. Yeah, it is. You're right.
It's a sport. This is not in a backyard right. brawl. And that's, you know, in order to uphold the integrity of MMA, I mean, I've been fighting for the sport for so long. And,
right. And you don't want to tarnish your record on that crap.
Yeah, I'm not going to spoil it because somebody wants to say fuck.
Yeah,
it's stupid.
That is stupid.
So
Nate Diaz will probably never fight in the AFC.
No, yeah, we'll just make sure that his the bleeping is, you know, under control.
Yeah,
and he's,
yeah.
No, I was going for Nate. I was there. Bet on Nate Diaz. I was.
Did you win?
Yeah, I won.
Did you win?
Big?
Yeah.
Well, if I would have bet more, I would have won more.
That's what I was asking.
But I bet $50.
What?
So
that's
I won
it?
200. Yeah, I'm not a better. I do not like to lose at all.
I'm with
and
her. Me and you.
I mean,
yeah,
I
bet $50 on him.
I bet.
You should.
I lost. No, before. I'm just joking.
I doubt that because I don't lose a lot of
you
fights.
Had one.
So you're saying
you
we should bet on you
saw.
For this upcoming?
What?
That we haven't talked about yet?
What?
The upcoming fight? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's talking about betting $50 on him.
Okay.
No, I'm not going to because I did it before and I already lost.
He said you should and he gave you the look and he pointed
at you.
So basically, if you don't, he's going to kick your ass.
How are you going to feel fighting at this weight though? Have you ever been this light in fighting? Are you gonna go all Conor McGregor?
I fought 180
catch
weight one time.
He went the other way. I know, but
yeah,
but your power is in your gut, brah.
My ass is still there.
You got them black jeans and the pants.
Well, hey, his name is Potbelly Ass Assassin.
Is your glutes
Assassin?
It's your glutes.
Yeah, it comes from the ground, not from your arms.
I thought that was only the case in like for boxing, like boxers.
You punch the same way.
It's
man.
It's punching. It's punching.
Okay, so you. But how's your ground game? What are you?
I'm gonna submit this guy in 2 rounds. So.
Oh my God, Conor McGregor. Conor McGregor says that all the time.
No, but
two
you
rounds
know,
or less.
It's gonna go down in the second round. You know,
no one can stand my left hand.
Yeah.
When it touches them, they fall down.
I don't know why.
Except for Nate
when
Diaz.
All the shit talking goes back and forth, like how come Nate Diaz never went like, oh, you know, shut up with your fucking Lucky Charms. Nobody brings up Lucky Charms with the guy.
Yeah, I don't know, but he did
Cerrone
say
did.
He beat up a
yeah,
bunch
Cerrone
of midgets.
Did.
Cerrone did.
Yeah,
did?
He said he beat up all of his midgets or whatever.
Yeah,
it
Nate
is.
Diaz said he. Oh yeah, you knocked out some midgets. Whoop de doo.
Yeah, yeah. Nate Diaz. I mean, his signature flip off, and what he said at the end of his fight, he's like, you know, talking
I'm
about,
not scared.
Yeah, oh yeah,
yeah. Well, yeah, no, yeah. He always says I'm not scared, but he said, what did he say at the end of his fight? It was like,
I don't remember.
He's like, I'm not surprised.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
He's like, yeah. He's like, I'm not surprised.
The funniest thing, motherfucker, is his winning, his total winnings for that night was 600,000.
Five.
No, but if he won, he got an extra 100,000.
No, it, that, right? That was a $100,000 bonus he got. Oh, that was a performance of the night, and then, yeah.
So he got a total of 600,000.
Yeah, but that's disclosed.
Okay,
but Conor McGregor made $7.2 million.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, you were all he only made $1 million. I was like, bullshit, no, brother. No. He made way more.
He would have hit, if he would have won, he would have hit over 10. But the problem is nobody knows yet because the pay-per-view numbers aren't even released.
And but what happened with his bet? Didn't he bet on himself pretty big too? No?
Diaz or Conor?
Conor.
Oh, I don't know.
I think he did. He was making comments on that. He goes, yeah, I lost here at betting too.
I was told by a very, very reliable source or somebody I would trust in the betting world to mortgage my house and bet it on Holly Holm. And thank God we didn't. I told my husband, I go, well, you want to mortgage your house and bet on? And he's like, no, probably not.
I think not.
And then honestly, we're like watching it in the second round. We're like,
I didn't see that shit coming. Like when it got that late in the fight, I was like, there's no way.
You know who we were sitting with? We're sitting with Ray Sifu, the president of World Series.
Yeah, he's awesome, dude.
And so he's sitting right behind us and he trains with Misha. He's like,
he's their head coach at Extreme Couture.
Yeah. So he's like, yeah, probably, you know, he goes, unless she gets to the ground. So we're like going in the second round. We're like, yes, you know, she's dominating. And then,
yeah, that whole round.
And then third, fourth. And we're like, though. And then Ray and I were talking. He said, you know, fifth round, the only chance she's got is a submitter. You know, and we're like, oh, you know, it was just insane. And then too much adrenaline dump.
Yeah.
Too much.
Because Holly, if it would have went to decision, she probably would have had
Holly
it.
Holly would have won.
She would have won.
Yeah. The only round that Misha had was the second round.
Third and fourth, for sure, easily.
Yeah, and she was winning. Yeah, she was winning the fifth round.
Yeah,
if she would have just held on for 30 or 45 seconds, she would have easily won the fight. And there's some stuff was just coming out today talking about like Dana talking about how dumb her manager is, cost her probably about $11 million because they were adamant about taking that fight with Misha. So if they would have waited for that Ronda fight,
it would have. It probably would have been.
It would have paid. Yeah. Well, who knows? It would have paid more.
Yeah, that's true. But I don't even know if Ronda can come back from that. I don't know.
She's talking about having babies. They're trying to.
Of her
wait,
recently?
She's talking about having a baby?
Yeah, with Travis Brown.
With Travis Brown.
Oh, good God.
Have you seen photos of her recently?
No.
She probably ballooned up a little bit, huh?
Getting big. She's bigger? Sure.
Yeah, they're trying to book her in October.
For Misha.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, they're trying to book her, but they're talking rematch is the latest that I've seen, but.
Well, see, but isn't that why Holly Holmes wouldn't fight her? Is because she didn't want to wait like a year to fight her?
Exactly. And that's
I don't blame her. I mean, really.
Well, you can't blame her for that because she's a fighter. She wants to get in there. And
she doesn't care about the money. She said it right. Yeah. We were watching the press conference and she's like, I don't care about the money.
I'm sure she cares about not having that gold belt around her waist anymore.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure she does too. And if I was in her scenario, I'd wait for the payday. I would. Yeah. I'd stay active and just continue to train. But I'm not a fighter either, so.
No, I'm a money whore.
that's saying that for me.
Yeah,
there's a big difference between a fighter and a money whore.
Yeah, it's like, Demetrius Johnson, he fought for us in Alaska, and I've kind of became friends with him and his wife. And for him,
I'm not going to lie, I can't wait till that guy gets beat. I'm sorry.
The thing is,
he's really good, but man. Yeah,
hold your breath.
Yeah, it's because you want to see a change. Everybody wants to see a change, but here's the deal. He goes in there, he does his job, like it or not. He trains. He doesn't shit talk. He doesn't do that. I like the shit talk. I like the days of the WWE. I like that excitement. But he says, it's my job to come in, fight, win, and continue on. Rat hole as much money as he can so he can retire. Right now he's trying for he's on Twitch a lot. So he's trying to make that his backup career, the streaming, video game streaming, where you talk to people. I don't get it.
Oh,
but,
yeah.
Yeah. I Googled that today.
He's really into it.
He's going to be the next PewDiePie.
People are into it. It's crazy that
I've got a friend that makes like $80,000 a year off of it.
Yeah,
off of Twitch.
They make money
dollars a year.
See,
that's why I know for a fact the show isn't going anywhere because
that probably because
the social media
reach
we just ain't
got.
We just I'm still trying to figure out how to use Snapchat.
I'm learning. I got a 14-year-old. I'm stoked.
Dude, I know. I was on Google today.
She's not in here. Yeah, my 14-year-old.
Okay, well you gotta add me on. Pull up your Snap thing or whatever, and then
I'll do it after.
Do that. Well, I got a challenge for you guys. So, you guys are gonna have to fight each other.
I'm down.
So,
I'll whip his ass.
Stoked.
Who's been training?
Back over here.
I only have one of my really cool hoodies. And so somebody gets a consolation prize of a beanie. The other person's gonna get the really cool hoodie. So
what do we got to do?
Uh oh.
Well, you got two choices. You could either thumb wrestle. Or rock, paper, scissors.
Or who can take the most punches to the face.
I thought you were going to say something else. And I was like, this is not that kind of show, my friend.
So here's the second prize.
That's the second prize.
Second prize is your beanie.
That's not a bad consolation prize.
This is awesome.
These are way better.
Oh, my gosh.
Get a freaking beer koozie in it.
What?
What? Shut up, really?
That's an open beer?
So I gave one to Dana. Yeah,
dude. I walked around the
And then the it also has a beer opener in your pocket.
Oh, we're going to have to thumb wrestle. I'm going to leave this up to no chance. I'm going to whoop your ass.
Hold on, let me get my hand nice and sweaty.
Uh-oh. So you're going to rub it on your...
Chehode.
Give it a little of that taint.
Oh, my goodness. So when Dana came, he was like, that is awesome. He's like, UFC doesn't even have those. He goes, but we will next week.
Oh, yeah. You gave him an idea.
You are the Dana White of Alaska.
No.
No, yes, you are.
Alaska for stop. Sure.
Yeah, Alaska. Sure.
I prefer Don King. Okay. Oh.
You don't have the hair.
You're not a fighter.
Yeah.
No, I love Dana White. He's my idol. I mean, he's obviously having him up to Alaska was just
incredible. How'd that change your guys'... you guys didn't have a relationship before he came up here, right?
I've met him, but I mean, he didn't know who I was.
And so from when he was up here, it seems like your relationship's kind of grown a little bit.
I was hoping to have some information for you guys on the podcast, but it's not ready yet. So
I was hoping too. I was like,
well, you know, we're just going to have you back.
Yeah.
That's okay. It sounds good. We're going to be open.
Yeah. But there's some cool things in the works for AFC. A lot of people are going to be super stoked. I'm stoked.
Dude, that's awesome. You know what's really frustrating is when someone like Dana White or even when Chuck Liddell came up here or whatever else, the place is packed out. You can barely move around in that damn thing.
Yeah.
But any other time, it's kind of like, I mean, it's half. It's like half, which is still cool. It's still a lot of people.
Yeah.
But I would like to see everybody else just kind of,
get on board. Well, here's the problem. We're every month. Okay. So it's not like there's only a select few of people that actually like MMA in Alaska. We're a small market. I mean, you go to a show I went to a show in downtown Honolulu, 400 people. That's it. I mean, so for us to pull 12 to 1,500 people every month is amazing. And that's what Dana said to us. He said it was the best mid-level promotion he had ever been to.
Whoa, that is awesome.
Boom. Alaska, bitches.
Yeah.
And he said, you don't understand what you actually have here. And after traveling and going to some of the smaller promotions, I love seeing different shows. And after traveling and seeing some, I've been, Washington, Hawaii. My husband actually ended up going to one in somewhere in the Midwest. He goes, do you want me to go check out this show and see? Because I learn every time I go to one. And you'd be surprised. People leave here, like Lauren Murphy. I mean, she talks about it all the time. She was
friends with her for a spell.
Yeah, she's...
I'm so proud of her, man.
She's awesome, man. And she goes, man, we really took it, for granted, AFC. And when we got down here to Florida, me and Joey shows are just crap. She goes, you wouldn't believe how crap the shows are. And so I forget that. Because then I come back home and I'm like, yeah, you know what? Because when you're in it, I don't think that my show is... I think it's good because, I work hard at it. But I always see these other promotions. Like, I've been to some top-level promotions. Well, I won't bring up ones that are still in business. But Strikeforce? I went to Strikeforce and at Tacoma Dome. And there might have been 1,500 people. Bob Sapp was fighting in the Tacoma Dome.
Wow.
And they had pyrotechnics and all this crazy. I was in the front row and I'm just so excited about Strikeforce, and I'm like, this is so awesome. And I show up, I'm like, where are the people? Because it doesn't make any sense to me. This is like a huge fight card in Tacoma, Nothing.
Wow, that is crazy.
Yeah, and so you don't, Invicta.
There's chickens running around in the back.
You think Invicta's a huge show? Doesn't look like it, doesn't it? Have you ever watched it?
Yeah, I've watched a couple of them, yeah.
Showed up, I went to one in LA, 400 people. They made it look like there's
thousands
because they group everybody together, they put them on the stage, and they have the camera right there. Huh. And I went with Demetrius, DJ, and then I went with ref Paul Stockler. And we're sitting in the back, and Cyborg's fighting, for God's sake. We're like, this is crazy.
Dude.
And so I walk right up to the ramp, and here's Cyborg. I'm slapping her hand. Whoa. Nothing. It was just, I'm a fan, so I just expect it to be bigger. And so it was really interesting just to see other shows, and it's all about programming. That's where the money is.
Okay. I was going to say, do you think that's a brilliant scheme to take all of your small crowd and group them together to make it look bigger?
They have to.
Yeah.
They have to.
They do that for commercials.
They're not going to show empty seats.
Nobody, yeah. Right.
That's what the UFC, so when we were at the UFC this last weekend, 3:30 is when the fights start. First prelim on Fight Pass.
We watched them. I know.
You watch them.
And then if you watch them on Xbox, there's no commercials, so the camera's back here.
Nobody
there. And I was like, are you kidding me?
Oh, yeah. Like,
I'd be there.
The under, what, for not sure. Undercard. What are they
called? The prelims. Well, it's
it's always empty. Nobody's there yet.
Oh, I'm there. I paid, you know, our tickets were $1,100 a piece. Do you think that I'm not going
to
be
you had
there?
To pay?
No, I didn't pay.
I didn't think so.
I'm just saying
you're best friends with Dana White.
No, I'm not best friends with Dana White. Actually,
you guys are
actually, what had happened was I originally had tickets through Dana White, but they had such a high celebrity request that I got bumped.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so they didn't have enough seats because Dana has a certain section.
Thanks a lot, J-Lo.
No, Reggie Bush.
No, it was Gerard Butler.
Yeah.
That
motherfucker. Leonardo DiCaprio.
I know.
Yeah, they were all there. So Paul hooked me up. My referee, he's my attorney. He's awesome. He ended up getting a couple seats
for
us.
Your referee is your attorney?
Yeah. That's how it happened, though. He started as my attorney. And then, he backs me up. But and he's huge in the fight game. Like, he helps fighters. I mean, he's helped Tom. He's helped all sorts of fighters. Just doesn't.
Good people.
He's good people. He doesn't charge them. He works a lot with fighters. That's how, actually, Demetrius Johnson, he started with him. He flew Demetrius up. Demetrius slept on his floor fought for me. And then when he knocked out Jesse
Brock
with that head kick, that's how he got his start in WC, because they saw it on Inside MMA.
Mm-hmm.
The matchmaker Reed Harris saw it on Inside MMA, offered him a fight in WC. I would kind of contribute that to Paul and him. I mean, this DJ was working $10 an hour as a forklift operator in Washington. That's what he was doing. And
another Rex Richards.
Came a long way, man.
Yeah, he came a really long way. I mean, literally, he was sleeping on Paul's floor or his couch.
That's
awesome.
That's pretty crazy.
Because Paul believed in him. Mm-hmm. Paul represented his coach Matt Hume down in Washington, and he said, "Hey, I got this kid. You get him up to Alaska." And so we don't have people don't understand. Like, we don't have the funds to bring people up unless it's like, title fight, or I have a budget. I have a very strict budget I have to stay to every single month, or we're not going to have AFC.
Mm-hmm.
Please
stick to it too.
And people are like, you need to pay the fighters more. I said, when you see me cruising around in a Bentley,
then
I'll pay you.
Yeah.
But I just bought a new truck, 10 years. My AFC truck had 200,000 miles on it. Like, I'm not, living this extravagant lifestyle. I'm just kind of like every Joe Schmo, but I want to make a living doing it. I'm not going to do it for free.
Right.
You
can't.
Yeah.
So is it fair to say you're like the equivalent of a small business owner?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
But it's a grandiose business, if anything.
Yeah. People always tell my daughter, "Oh, your mom's rich." No.
No.
No. Because they see this big thing.
Right.
And it's not, you calculate it out. Start crunching numbers. You got 1,200 people there. I mean, you would assume that the Sullivan Arena is pretty spendy to rent.
Hell yeah.
I mean, I'm risking my butt every single month hoping that people walk in the door. And I've done that for 10 years.
Get
and
out to the fights, you bastard.
Yeah, sometimes.
Yeah, get out there. Get out there. Support
I mean, you can go $20, $20 to the fights. And you can get a discount ticket. And it's a movie,
We're very fortunate because me and my wife on you have been able to go because of the t-shirts.
Yep.
For free. Yep. But it doesn't matter because we end up giving tickets away and still going because it's something that it's live entertainment.
Right.
And
right.
It's awesome live entertainment. And there's booze. And
what is one of the major complaints about Alaska? We don't have live entertainment.
But that's what I'm saying is that
so when it's provided to you on a monthly basis,
religiously.
With love, fucking go.
Yeah,
go.
We pulled our summer cards in the summer months because people weren't coming. I get that.
Well,
I want to be fishing too.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But I was losing like $30,000-$40,000 a show.
Right.
In the summer.
We were upset because we still went in the summer. And when we found out it stopped, we were like, damn, what are we going to do for date night? Because that's what we do.
Yeah. Well, what I was doing?
I was
sitting on the couch eating bonbons making $30,000 is what I was doing by not losing my ass.
Yeah.
So
what do you do in the summer when everything's closed up? Okay, so you take time off and...
Well, I get about 6 weeks off because I started an outdoor show at Coots. We're doing it again this year, so it'll be Land of the Midnight Sun 3.
Yeah!
So that's June 11th, and then so from June 11th...
What date does that land on?
It's a Saturday, I think. Friday or Saturday? Saturday.
I can make that.
And then so I go... Maybe. My husband and I have a place on the Kenai, and we fish.
So you go down there and party. Which is perfect because everybody out of state loves Alaska, so you're going to have Dana White and all these other... Big ass people wanting to go fishing and hanging out.
Yeah, but
outside.
You know what? It's weird because like we took Sean Shirk fishing. We've done a few things. Randy Couture, I got to go. Oh man, that was awesome. Randy Couture is like my all time favorite fighter.
But I'm I just so got right shivers now. All up and down my
Chuck.
Balls.
Huh?
Can
we be
Chuck.
Best friends?
Chill. Whatever. Just because he does know my first name though. That's for sure. Well, and I saw.
Ooh,
But he sat on my toilet. He pooped in my toilet. We're good. We're pretty much like family.
Randy bought me and my dad.
He's got herpes. I've got herpes.
Oh, stop. Sorry. Oh, my God.
It's forever.
Obviously. I'm sorry, Sarah. I'm telling you, stay away from you.
Sorry.
Sarah, I'll make some room for
you. Yeah, just watch the wires.
Hey, I'm not as disgusting as Joey Diaz, dog. I'm not as disgusting.
Yeah, Joey Diaz.
All right, let me tell you something.
No,
right.
Please don't tell me something.
Oh, my God.
Anyways.
Randy
bought you.
Randy was.
Thank you, Tommy, for stepping in.
Sorry about that.
He was the most genuine, like down to earth, because I've dealt with a lot of fighters, and they are prima donnas, and they expect you to pay for everything. They're not very polite. I mean, I've had anything from feeling very uncomfortable having to bring a fighter with me in the car before.
Really?
Like, oh yeah, when I fly people up and stuff, you just never know what to expect. And
yeah,
I mean, Tony Lopez, straight up, he hit on me so bad the first time he came up, and then he brought his wife the second time. I'm like,
and did he still hit on you? He's like, hold on, baby.
Yeah, no.
What's up, Sarah? You want to get a little homo homo?
Yeah, he didn't.
I think I drove him that time.
Yeah, I think you did too. I wasn't comfortable. Tommy's like the chauffeur for the fighters. I'm like, here, take him.
You know, and that's what one people that they fail to realize is that these are just regular people.
Yeah,
and
they
it's
are.
It's hard to get that through your head.
It took me years. I'm still fangirl. Yeah. I go and I'm like, oh my God. I went to an after party. I actually got to go to Dana's party, like his after party two fights ago, and I was hanging out with him, Frankie Edgar, Verdum. I'm like freaking out.
Name
I'm like
driving.
Sitting there.
Oh my
keep
God.
Going. Keep going.
And Annie
like
came,
the ultimate fan experience. Well,
the girl, cage girl Annie, came with me and she's so cool. She's kicked back. I'm not. I'm like sitting there not saying anything. It was anything that you could think of to drink. Or, you know, the waitresses are out. I'm just sitting there like, and I'm, and I dress. Yeah, I wear like leggings and sweaters and like I'm very conservative.
Sure.
So I'm like boots. And so I get there and there's all these girls with these.
Like, look like hookers?
Well, they might have been, but we were like,
what? Talking like, it was Vegas. Like mini skirts.
Vegas.
And,
oh, Annie said, Vegas? She's like, okay. I didn't see how, can't even believe how many.
Boobs?
No. Vaginas I saw.
I was going to say, yeah, I can't believe that girl wore a vagina to this party.
Yeah, that's how it was. And they were all, and Annie shows up in like black jeans and chucks, and you know, we're just very kickback. And so we're like walking by, and the girls are just giving us.
I'd rather see a girl in black jeans and chucks, probably.
Yeah, she.
That's her vagina first meeting. Hey, how you doing? I'm Chris.
No, yeah. it kind of breaks the ice. If you could see
maybe that's some ice you don't want broken, brother.
No, break that ice all day, bro. You want me to take my pants off?
So the girls give us a dirty look as we're walking by.
Not as much as you talk about herpes.
They want to get into this party, and they weren't in. They were like on the outside. And so we get led, because I became friends with Dana's head of security. His name's Kea. Really cool guy from Hawaii. He took us, and you know, we went over, and the girls just giving us dirty looks. There's only one other woman in this area, and there's like Frank Fertitta, the big Frank, you know, Frank Fertitta, not even Lorenzo.
The money.
$3 billion, you know. No, he's worth $3 billion.
Dana's boss.
Yeah. So like Frank Fertitta, I've never been around a billionaire, okay, let alone a $3 billionaire. And I'm just like, this is freaking nuts, you know. I'm like, and they're just so cool. They're like, hey, you want a drink? You know, this, that. And so I'm still not over that whole like shock thing.
Fangirl?
I think every time I ever see Dana White, I'm a fangirl. I don't care.
I don't care either. I agree.
It is what it is.
Totally.
You know?
Oh, yeah.
Every time I see him, I'm just like, my husband
follows
me around.
Honestly, you
wouldn't
be as passionate about this if you weren't a fangirl.
Yeah.
Right. So.
My husband, he doesn't care. And so he like follows me around with the camera and he's like, you want me to get a picture? You want me to get a picture? So I'm like,
hell yeah.
You know, like every, it's just so stupid.
So you don't have to do this shit? You're not
I'll do it. I don't care if he's not around.
You actually have a photographer following you around.
Yeah, and see, Liddell is actually my
sponsor.
I wish.
That's awesome.
No, he's Liddell, Couture, and Chael Sonnen have to be my all-time three.
So. Chuck Liddell is in my top three for sure.
Yeah,
for sure. I hate to say it.
I got Donald in there.
Why?
No. He's in. I was gonna hate to say the one of the other.
Who's
two.
The one?
Conor McGregor.
That's okay.
What are you talking about, dude?
He's Irish.
He's awesome. A ginger.
He's okay. Irish. I'm Irish. Let's fucking go.
I don't care, dude. You know what? This is the best thing that ever happened in the UFC was Conor McGregor and Ronda Rousey. Well, especially Ronda Rousey. Because of the personality.
My third, you're not going to get that.
Okay, sorry, go ahead.
You can guess all day.
I'm Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Brock Lesnar.
I don't know. Is he a fighter?
Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Get to the chopper. Yeah.
I was proud of Brock for trying, but no.
I know who you're going to say. You're going to say John Jones Bones.
No. Natural born killer.
He's one of my favorite too, man. Carlos Condit.
Carlos Condit. Yeah.
Wait, no, it's like this.
Here, go. Get in your mic, Tommy.
Yeah.
Right? You can actually, if you want, take this.
Oh, and then.
maybe like slightly. Yeah, and then get pulled over
without
face,
insurance again.
Hey, I love him. I love.
He had the best
Jones.
Shit talking with. They had a press conference
with Cormier.
Oh yeah, and Weidman and Luke Rockhold. I just love their shit talk. I love it.
You know what? I hope Jones, whatever.
Johnny Bones Jones.
Thank you. I hope he whoops the shit out of him.
He's gonna, I don't care for DC. He doesn't have a choice or a chance. I already saw the first one. You know why is the second one going to be different?
Wait,
who
doesn't have a chance? No, he won.
Who doesn't have a chance?
DC.
No. Oh, yeah. Okay, DC, I thought you were going the other way. I was like.
No.
Wait, so you're going for JBJ.
I'm not going for him.
We're just
going to
call him JBJ from now on.
DC, I have the shirt that says Break Bones, and I'll continue to wear it, but DC doesn't have a chance.
No, he doesn't. And he talks so much shit, and I hate it. Dude, ugh, I can't stand that.
I like the shit talking.
I know, but I don't like him.
I like the cake.
Are we still talking about DC?
Yeah.
Hey, he's a fat boy like me. Have you seen his cake?
Dude, you make money.
Video?
You haven't seen the video?
I'm all about that cake.
I'm all about that cake. I did. Fried chicken.
Okay, it was funny. I admit, I laughed.
That was funny. But, I mean, how much money do you make, bro? Get that fucking gap filled in. Come on.
Yeah. No, it's a style.
I'm Dan Cormier. Style.
Dude, you could kick a football through them fucking things.
It's like the field goal post of the Super Bowl.
Oh, I just dropped the F-bomb. That's like number two in like nine episodes.
Yeah, he doesn't drop them. Whenever he wants to say the F-word, he winks at me.
Oh.
And I say it for him.
Well, are you guys going to fight?
What?
Yeah, we got off track.
Are we thumb wrestling?
Prizes, yeah. Okay. prizes.
All right, so
let me get this out of the way. You can Indian leg wrestle.
She's just so willing to come in here and give
wants
us
to
stuff.
Piss against each other.
I had the Rock'em Sock'em, but you know it wasn't as vicious. So
what we need to do for next time? We'll set up another camera over there next to the mat, and we'll go at it on the floor. How about
you should.
That? Let's do that. I'd like that. I would love to make. We would love to make a regular showing with. You, of course, but also
the fighters would love it.
We would, because that's what I don't hear a lot of. I do hear some people go on Bob and Mark every once in a while,
yeah,
but it's not really
it's not even Bob and Mark anymore, it's Bob and Ted.
He fought last night,
did he really?
No. He boxed.
How'd he do?
No, he won, I guarantee he won.
Everybody said he didn't win, and the judges gave it to him.
I've never met the guy,
even Chad said it.
Cleanest boxers I've ever seen.
Chad said it himself. The judges,
really?
Yeah, he said I didn't win the fight.
Was it Chad? Is a kind of a good looking guy, and I kind of judge things off the way people look.
I trained with him for about 5 years. Give it to him.
He's a badass. He is a badass.
5 years.
Oh yeah, I didn't even know.
I trained with him at Great Land for 5 years.
You listen to him on the radio, and you think he was like the way he talks about like him being like,
I'm sorry. Did you say Great
homophobe,
Land?
But
Great Land martial arts.
Yeah.
Hey, there's
you train there.
I work with Master Trevor Martin.
Trevor had the MMA program there for a little while.
Yeah, I don't do MMA with him. I'm just Taekwondo. Straight
I know.
Taekwondo.
I think he only does Taekwondo now.
Hapkido, Judo.
But yeah. I mean, not the MMA program's gone.
Yeah, he doesn't do that anymore.
Yeah.
Okay, how are we going to do this? Are we going to?
Yeah,
like,
I don't know. Okay. Like right here, we need a referee.
So we're just going to go over
you
the table.
The ref.
Okay, I'll be the referee.
You're the ref and the judge.
I'm so nervous. We're going to do behind him. How about that?
Okay.
Right across from him, like this.
Well, we need one camera.
Like this.
Right here. All
right.
I got my let me get out of the way.
Yeah, let him over there, Tommy.
We're just going to get this shit going.
Okay. Tommy, you're going to ref. You know how to do that. Oh!
Motion's 11.
There we go.
Yep. Honestly, I'll just throw the fight. You can have the hoodie. I just want the hat.
Okay, that's fine.
I'm just kidding.
Don't say that.
Hell no. I ain't throwing a fight to you. Big old pussy.
50 versus a 15.
All right. I'm not a very good commentator, so.
I'm looking at the camera.
Okay. Line them up, Tommy. Ready? Actually, should we arm wrestle?
So
I like arm wrestling.
Are we doing one, two,
let's do a break. Let's do a break.
Wait.
Bro, is it one, two, three, go, or is it one, two, go?
No, it's one, two, three, four. I declare a thumb war.
Right, okay, go for it.
Okay, ready?
One, two, three, four. I declare a thumb war.
Oh my gosh, you are so strong. Your hands, you got the midget hands. Oh, you got to count.
You got to count to three.
Oh my God, I'm gonna lose. What? Oh, you're slippery. You did rub your nuts.
Oh,
he's like, "What'd you
last forever?" Let's arm wrestle.
Tag team.
No, tap back.
You're doing this. You keep doing this.
Yeah, you need to keep the clench going.
Okay,
there you go.
There you go.
Hey,
you guys didn't even shake.
You keep pulling your hand out. I'm not. Keep stop pulling your hand.
One, two, three.
What are you pulling your hand out like that? Oh my God, oh my God.
I have a broken thumb.
What do you guys got?
A broken thumb.
All right, it's going to have to be a rock, paper, scissors. This is pathetic.
Or we can arm wrestle.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors.
Oh, my God.
Wait, don't walk away. He's got to do it on camera. What are you talking about?
He's got a camera.
I got a camera.
Woo!
I did have
I'm out of breath.
He's like, he's huffing.
I work out. What do you do?
Nice try.
Did you just say that a couple minutes ago?
Yeah.
I do believe so.
He did.
Am I huffing and puffing?
Apparently, you don't do cardio in your thumbs.
I don't have thumb cardio for sure.
Dude, I can't even move mine now. That's the most exercise I've had in the past week. Sorry, year.
Oh, my God.
So
it's...
Rock paper scissors. Don't do that. Please.
Okay, now this is very important because
don't do this.
You have to. Do you go?
I win.
It's on rock paper scissors.
Chris,
not appropriate.
No, I win. All right, so
a money shot.
That's how it is. One, oh God, two, sweating. Three, and then go.
Yeah,
one,
rock,
two,
three, paper, shoot. Scissors.
One,
rock,
two,
paper, push. Scissors, and then you go.
Go on the fourth.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Yeah. Rock, paper, scissors,
shoot. Okay. Lord Jesus, please.
He's going to throw a rock.
It's best out of five.
Best out of five?
Yeah.
Okay.
Whoa. Best out of five.
Okay, ready?
That's the only way to play.
Okay. Ready.
He's throwing a rock. Watch him.
Damn it. You
oh, why would you do that to psych him out?
Dude, I can't believe that crap. I have no idea.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, my God.
I read his mind.
Mind control.
I'm sorry.
One to one. Or no, 1-0.
Nothing.
Okay, 1-0. That's right.
He's throwing rock.
Okay, go.
You
are you really gonna throw a rock again?
That hoodie probably don't even fit you, bro.
Wait, is it a double XL?
No,
it
it's
is
a tall.
Double X.
Oh, it'll fit him then.
You son of a.
Oh. They do run small though.
They run small.
See, they run small.
Sweet, it'll fit me then.
That's how it won't fit you. Is what he's saying.
Okay, 1-0.
All right.
Oh, he did go rock again.
1-1.
Damn it. I'm going to listen to him.
You are nothing but a son of a bitch.
All right. 1, 2, 3.
Ah, son of a bitch.
Oh. Okay.
One more,
and it's his.
What am I going to do? Paper, scissors,
rock.
Rocks?
It's me rock again.
Oh,
you know it's not going to be
you
now.
You suck. What did you throw already?
I ain't telling you.
He threw a paper
one,
and a scissors.
1, 2, 3, 4.
That's it.
I get
dun,
a hoodie.
Dun, dun. Winner.
Hey, at least he gets one that fits him.
I've been working.
I made him a shirt a while back and it didn't fit him.
I've been working this out all day, bro.
Here we go.
I got it. Yeah.
It'll fit you.
Yeah. Look at that.
See, you got to put it on and put your beer on in there.
And in, the, and in the sport of not being a sore loser.
Oh, that's very
way
sweet.
To go, boy. Good job, buddy. Good job.
Very sweet.
I'm like Conor McGregor. I'm gracious in winning and in defeat.
Over the headphones?
Dude, I feel gangster in this thing.
Pretty gangster.
It's super comfortable, too.
It is,
man.
Comfortable.
I love them.
And it has a koozie in there.
And you put your beer in there right now.
What?
You know, see, I called it, though. I said I wanted the hat anyway. Yeah, I love beanies.
So
I got
you were
like
just,
a massive
well, if you love number. Beanies, these just came out, and there's only 20, 20 of them. So March is MS Awareness Month.
Well aware, my dear.
So... Tommy has graciously agreed to donate the proceeds of his fight pay. He's selling tickets. Whoa. He's selling t-shirts to the Alaska MS Center. So we had 20 of these made up.
Wow.
And they're the Potbelly Assassin beanies. They're selling for $20. All proceeds go to the Alaska MS Center. And
are you serious right now?
Yeah.
What that mean, is amazing.
About donating?
Yep.
That is amazing.
I do that at least once or twice a year, every year.
That is yep. Wow. So
I go in there and I fight and put my... body online for nothing. I don't get paid anything. So.
That
he donates
amazing.
Everything. He did it for Special for Olympics, and then this year, I was diagnosed with MS a year and a half ago, and my sister said, "Hey, you know what? Why don't we do?"
I'm sorry, you were?
I have MS. So
2012.
You were too? Are you shitting?
This is.
Me?
Why do you think my truck's orange?
Why do you think his headphones are?
Are
orange?
You serious?
Why do you think my headphones are orange? Why do you think?
Why do you think our new logo is orange?
Holy shit! Yeah. I had no idea. Why do you think my logo is orange?
The thing is that
don't talk about it.
It's like you as yourself, you guys are strong people, and you kind of own what you got, and you mm-hmm. got, you know, and you're helping people out every single time the AFC comes around. People know, not necessarily about you, but right. about, you know, they know that, you know, because you're spreading awareness all over the place every single time. It's great. It's awesome. And him too, he's owned it. He's never said it publicly.
Right.
He doesn't tell anybody.
Yeah, I didn't want to come out originally when
like
it first happened.
I didn't want to come out, but...
you know, it's because
you're
go back
in the MS
forth.
Closet.
Well, yeah.
I have MS in my game.
And honestly, if I... Yeah, exactly. If I had a day job, like an actual like 9-to-5 job, I don't think I would have because they do discriminate against you. And I mean...
Wait, for what?
You
calling
actually
in sick. I mean, all sorts of things. That,
they ask you a lot of jobs. Yeah. Oh, really? They ask you when you apply for jobs. Now, does that do you have any
insurance as well with
disabilities? It's a disability.
Yeah, it's a disability. Oh,
okay.
So with MS, you're considered 100% disabled. Actually, so
I could collect. We both could collect disabled benefits, right?
Yeah,
now.
But
don't waste them.
Yeah, exactly. It's not. I'll use it when I need it. When I can't work anymore.
I love
so,
it. I love it. That's so awesome.
But for the time being, so it's considered a disability. And so, like he said, at work and stuff, they'll ask you, you know. But I run my own business, and I figured that I could spread awareness. I got involved with the group, Alaska MS Center. They're a small local group that helped me when I first got diagnosed, and because I didn't know where to go. It's like you got an 800 number, you know, you got this. And, I mean, your family doesn't know, you know. Your family doesn't know what's going on.
Oh, it's cool.
It's crazy.
I use the power of denial. Honestly, yeah. I'm not going to lie. There's all these places to say, and you're saying that you actually reached out to some of these places, and I don't.
I didn't. I didn't at first.
I know I should, but I don't. I just.
But the problem was, is I was sick for so long, not knowing, and that was the hardest part of it. So
now see me even knowing him who has MS, I don't know what you're going through. He doesn't talk about it.
And so most people,
which is fine, and I never have asked. Hey, but
if it makes you feel any better, my wife probably doesn't know what I'm going through 75% of the time.
Because you don't talk. Yeah, it's a burden.
So what's okay, if you had it like an underlying, like, okay, these are symptoms or whatever.
Sure, I'll give you a brief rundown of MS, of what MS actually is. So MS is it's a neurological disease. It's pretty much in layman's terms, because I still don't understand the technical term of it, but it's autoimmune disease, which they think it's autoimmune disease. They still aren't 100% sure.
Yeah, not 100% sure.
Yeah. Right? So, and they say it's environmental, and you know, there's all these different things. They don't know why people
above
are getting
the equator,
it.
If you're of European descent.
Yep. The further away from the equator, the higher rate of MS. They think it's something tied with vitamin D deficiency, because every person that has MS has low vitamin D. And so that was one of the first things they found with me, but never really put two and two together. They're like, well, your vitamin D is extremely low. Let's put you in some vitamin D. But it was 2 years. It took 2 years for them to finally figure out what was going on with me. But I got to the point where I could barely even walk on my right hand side. My face was numb from the top of my head all the way down here. I couldn't taste, couldn't hear, couldn't feel. And that went on, and they told me I had Bell's palsy, and that went on for about 4.5-5 months.
And that's a common misdiagnosis.
Yeah.
It's common.
A lot
Bell's
of
palsy.
Most people that get diagnosed with MS get what they call optic neuritis. And that is, so let's go back. Your body attacks itself.
Yeah.
So
can I throw something that'll help you out? It's demyelination.
Yep.
Myelin is,
the insulation.
It's like a sheath that goes around your nerves. And what MS does, and we don't know why, is it attacks
cells
and
attack
it starts to eat that myelin away. And eventually it gets through the myelin and then starts eating that nerve that's inside.
So it creates a short circuit between the areas of
and,
that.
And then you get temporary paralysis. Is it?
Yeah.
Is it so people with MS actually they'll have like get blind?
Oh,
like,
they do.
You go blind, you can.
Is this without medication, or can this be controlled?
I wouldn't even call it controlled.
No, it's not controlled. So it's a degenerative disease, mm-hmm. and typically there's three different levels of MS. I was diagnosed with the least, the relapsing remitting, which takes a long, long, long time. Because you know they could have said, "Oh, you have progressive, and you'll be in a wheelchair in a year."
Yeah, progressive is.
Yeah. So I was blessed that I was relapsing and remitting when we finally figured it out, but it's a degenerative disease. And if you don't stay active and you don't take care of yourself, it's going to go faster. And that's the bottom line. I go to Swedish MS Center in Seattle. I got a specialist down there because I had nothing but problems with neurologists here in Alaska, and there's no MS specialist here. None. Zero.
That's freaking ridiculous.
So, the medical care, I mean, and then the drugs that they have you on and everything else, it's an absolute nightmare, but it's crazy because there's 2,500 people just in Alaska that's living with it that has came forward and said to their doctors.
How 11, many?
2,500. That's
holy crap. That's huge.
That's huge. For
I mean,
it's amazing when you get something and then you find out how many other people have it. Like I'm fucking shocked. I'm shocked.
It's crazy. But that's why I started last year. My sister came to me. She's like, "Well, why don't we do MS awareness and you can talk to people about it?" And because the group was really awesome. I went cross country skiing with them because I no longer could snowboard. I could no longer do all the things that I used to do. I don't have the balance to do it. And so they kind of took me in.
Was this then?
This was right after I found out I was diagnosed. Okay. It all made sense. It's like me and my husband went for anniversary snowboarding. I went all the way up chair 6. I couldn't get down. I couldn't stand up. I didn't know why. And so afterwards, we just adjusted the lifestyle. Said, okay, well, we're going to take cross-country skiing lessons. So you've got both poles on the ground. And but that's what the MS group does. They do these group outings that make you feel more like a normal person, and families can participate. It's really cool. My husband did it. My daughter did it. My in-laws did it. They were super supportive, and it just kind of made you feel more normal, because you really kind of feel when we kind of first find out, like an outcast, like nobody understands, no, you know. And I'm sure that's with any disease, you know, because unless you're living it, you don't know. It's an invisible disease, is what they say. It's not like my arm got cut off, or right. you have cancer and you don't have any hair, or right. you know, people look at you and they're like, "Oh, yeah, you're fine. Normal. You yeah. look great." And after I was diagnosed, they're like, "Gosh, you look so great."
There's one side effect I've noticed so far to MS, though, that is being awesome, because you guys are the only two people I know. That are, you guys are pretty freaking cool. So if everybody with MS
stronger.
Has awesome,
I mean, it definitely makes it you stronger. Yeah. And so I kind of did some soul searching. I thought, you know what? I have a platform to tell people about this, and why not, you know? Yep. So we did March. So my sister fought last year, and she ended up raising like $5,000 for the Alaska Mass Center. People donated, she sold shirts and did all, you know, a bunch of stuff. And it was really emotional for her. It was a really, really hard fight. And it was super emotional. I think she's done. She's like, you know, I went out on, that's what I wanted to do. It's her third fight. And it was an absolute war with this girl, and she did it for me, and I mean, she was bawling. It was just super emotional. My God. And but I did, you know, I felt like that my purpose was completed. You know, I felt people come up to me, and I have people come up to me all the time now. They're like, "Oh, I have Crohn's disease, or I have this autoimmune disease, or I have this." I mean, all these people are coming out of the woodworks that I had no idea. And autoimmune diseases are so rampant. Like, MS is just one of them.
It's an inspiration, just like with him losing weight. It doesn't matter, because knowing that you have this debilitating disease that you could still push through and do something like you're doing. It's amazing. Right. It's awesome.
Yeah, you have to have a positive attitude. I'm not going to lie. It's
tough as shit, I bet.
Freaking tough.
I can attest to that, because my wife isn't as secretive about what my wife has lupus. She was diagnosed in 2004, like right... pretty much after we started dating.
That's freaking just met crazy. Her.
So she has lupus.
And you have MS.
And I have MS. And she, and it's the positive attitude. My wife is one of the most positive people I've ever met. And
it's so hard to do it.
And then I almost feel bad that I hide my emotion and how I'm feeling from it. But, you know, she's already dealing with a whole shitload of things. Why do I want to burden her with that? My job for the first... I got diagnosed in 2012. So the first 8 years of our relationship, take care of your wife. Rawr. And I had weird things going on with my body, but I didn't know what the hell it was.
Right. Yeah.
Then when I got diagnosed, I was all, oh.
That makes sense. Yeah. When you're tired and you're this and that.
That's fatigue why I had vertigo for two straight fucking weeks. I didn't know why.
Yeah. That's, I had it at the outdoor show. So when I,
the ground looked like it's 30 feet away.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Is there something that propels it at certain times? Because
super cold weather.
Heat.
If you get overheated, your body, you're
immediately.
Yeah.
Short circuits. Any sort of inflammation. I take cold
showers regularly.
Yep.
So I have just a change in the weather.
Oh, we went to Florida on a cruise, and I couldn't even barely walk to the cruise ship. My husband drugged me. I went to Stagecoach two years before I got diagnosed. We thought somebody spiked my drink. They call it the drunk disease, MS, drunk disease. We thought somebody. I had a couple beers at the Stagecoach. My sister dragged me 3 miles to the cab line. I was sick. I couldn't walk. I couldn't move my legs.
Thought you got roofied or something.
Yeah, we thought I got roofied. We had no idea. And then 2 years later, we found out I got diagnosed. But so heat, inflammation, anything that it's hard because it's like, okay, alcohol.
Here's a real fucked up thing about it. It's always vitamin D deficiency is always associated with MS, but you can't be in the sun.
Yeah.
What the hell? So do you have to? So
fuck you, buddy.
Yeah. So pills.
I take 50,000 units every twice a week.
Now, is it a medication? That's
it's a supplement.
No,
it's
I take 4,000. Like, I use
a buddy of mine had both his kidneys. They were gone, and he has this anti rejection medicine or his medicine, so he can't be in the sun at all.
Is that we can be in the sun? We can go out in the sun. But you just don't want to get overheated.
Oh, okay. It's not like okay.
And never mind. I thought what happens in Alaska, especially, and that's probably why maybe above the equator is such an issue.
Well,
because we don't have a lot of sun, and then when we do,
Canada,
we're in it.
North.
Look at my bikini.
It's the Northwest, so they think like Canada and the Northwest. And we have the highest in North America. It's Canada and Alaska have the highest per capita of MS. So there's some sort of tie.
Maybe it's something else. Maybe it's like moose or something.
I was proud of being Irish my whole entire life until 2012.
What happened in 2012?
Fuck you.
Well, there's one
when I got diagnosed. 2012.
There's one.
Did we not cover that, Tommy? Yeah. You're keeping notes, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I smoked before you guys got here, so my mind's not here, bro. I was like, you know what? Joe Rogan, he gets high all the time, and he's like, you know,
they were
on it.
They were like on it, like
was prophetic.
You're welcome, Joe Rogan.
Joe Rogan just got plugged, bitch.
Dude, you're gonna have like five people twice. Look it up.
He was like
all from Alaska.
He was like 45 minutes late. All the guys like coming on the stage, and we're like sitting there, like, yeah, we know what you're doing.
He's briefing. I love him. I love him. I tell you what, if there's like when Dana came on here.
Yeah, with Nick.
Wait a second. That
weed
was
before
issue.
Speed. That's what they said. Weed before speed on the Conor McGregor fight.
Didn't Dana White like say like? Didn't he stop the whole if you've been smoking, then you're in trouble or whatever because of Joe Rogan? Because Joe Rogan's like, dude, he's open about
smoking.
That's
why he doesn't fight.
No. But he's still employed by
UFC.
UFC.
He's still employed by them, but he's not a fighter. So there's totally different rules.
Fighters have to be clean. They can't smoke.
They're drug tested.
But what I'm saying is they stopped the drug testing for regular employees.
I've got a question
because
for Tommy
of Joe Rogan. That's what I heard.
Oh, I don't know if they did.
Because he smokes like a mother.
I got a question. He does the oil. He does. I got a question for the Potbelly Assassin. If Joe Rogan stepped into the ring, would you fight him?
No.
That dude is fucking insane.
Are you kidding me? Are you an idiot?
Oh, yeah, dude.
No. Are you an idiot? If Joe Rogan came in here right now and said, I'll fight, well, not here, but in the ring.
Wait, are you talking money?
Yeah, okay. I'd do it. Beat my ass. Either way. I'd do it for free. I'd do it for $10,000.
It'd be pretty hard to turn down
That's
a fight.
That's not free, I'd, ass.
Well, what, compared to him, he's
I don't turn down a lot of fights, man. So I fought Andy Enns on like 20 hours notice.
But I'm talking Joe Rogan, and you've seen this,
Joe Rogan, because they'd be like,
have you watched any of his like Taekwondo
stuff? His kicks aren't even the scariest part. He's a black belt in jiu-jitsu.
That dude
is messing with him.
Who gives a crap?
Have you ever rolled with a black belt?
I rolled with a dude that had no experience, and my ass got whooped. I was like,
rolling with a black belt is miserable.
I'd still do it. I don't care.
I doubt you would.
Just for Joe Rogan to touch me for that long?
Okay.
Sign me up.
Hey, so
get his I'm going to try to get this podcast to Joe Rogan. He's got to watch it.
I know. Actually, we have yet to announce this. I'm kind of skipping ahead, and I'm sorry, but the way he brought that up, we actually, when we had Jeff on, the gym he trains at on base, we're kind of working with one of the guys. We're actually going to go on there and do kind of a video of us getting our asses handed to us in an MMA gym.
I definitely want to see that.
And I guarantee you, after that day, I know I'm going to hate life. You're going to be like, I don't want to fucking roll around Joe Rogan.
You act like I'm this out-of-shape piece of pudding.
Dude, I bet you're an out-of-shape piece of pudding, but you always say, Dave, Coos, you look good. And I don't know if you're boosting my ego or if I'm actually getting my workouts. But
have you seen me?
I would bet you.
I'm just saying. No, after we do that, I'm going to be fucking miserable.
I want to see you guys get in the ring and just at least spar.
So now imagine we rolling with Joe Rogan. He's going to kick you in the gut. You're probably going to go.
Yep.
Can't breathe. And then
he's just going to choke you out.
Yeah. And
I was just about
to. He probably won't even choke you out like legit. He's just going to go like two fingers on your knee.
He'd be like,
go to sleep, bitch.
Yeah.
On the forehead.
Joe Rogan, I'm calling you out. This isn't my space like that other douchebag, but I'm calling you out.
Oh, my God.
I'm calling you out. I want to fight.
Dude, I bet
you're going to have to fly me wherever you
are. But I'll be there.
I bet you would barf during warm-ups at a practice.
Dude, I did 3 minutes.
Either one of you guys.
Like I was telling him before, I did three minutes at a rolling session with this dude that was like 170 pounds. I'm 230 some odd pounds. This dude manhandled me for 3 minutes, and when I got up, I sat right back down. And the world was going, woo, woo, woo.
I'm in the same boat. That's not my thing. That's why I'm a promoter, and that's why I don't
feel. I just did a cardio workout the other day, and I was like, I went down to I put my hands on my knees and I was trying to breathe and everybody's like, no, don't do that. And I'm like, okay. So I stood up and I was like,
oh,
that was awesome. I'm training. We have a national team at the, Trevor and a Master T.
You need to get a cooling vest. Get a cooling vest.
Would be fantastic.
They prescribe them to you. Go to your doctor and I have one. And cause I'm running
second. Fat and I,
you can't just buy
sweat.
A cooling
it's
vest.
Disgusting.
It has to get
Well, I mean, you can get your insurance to pay for it. It's a medical thing.
Really?
So you
a prescription. Yeah.
You soak it in water. And it stays cold for a really long time. And it has some sort of fabric.
There's a guy that was online that was using it to lose weight.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So they'd wear those cooling vests outside. Actually, it was in Canada. Crazy-ass Canadian.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
So they'd wear these vests, and they'd go outside and run in the winter. And they used it to shock the system.
Wait, wouldn't that
fucking
freeze
them?
Yeah, no. I don't know. But
it goes from cooling vest to ice vest in no time.
Yeah.
And they sold me a
hypothermia vest.
Exactly.
Hey, that works.
I hate. Oh, he's using his new hoodie.
I would totally buy one.
Look at me. I'm using my new hat. Wait.
For free.
Cover the eyebrows.
Yeah, but they make those, and they actually make the ones over that you can put around. Because I like, if I go, it's a 5K or something. My husband likes to do those, and I'll do them outside in the winter. Mm. And we did one, and as soon as I got to the end of it, my legs just collapsed because they get rubber. It's like when you get hot, you know. And I'm like ripping off all my clothes because normally you have to have like a hoodie on and all that stuff. Yeah. And so
layers are the worst. Layers are great, but you have to actually remove them.
Yeah, as you're going,
and then you got to put them back on. A pain in the ass. So.
Yeah, it's a very weird thing, but you learn to adjust and you just deal with it. But the cooling vests are saviors for people to.
Tommy.
Here we go. Oh. Let's do a little.
Higher. I thought he was doing another one.
The same one.
No, we gotta. We gotta keep this boy in shape. And why do we have to keep this boy in shape, Sarah?
He's fighting on Wednesday.
Who are you fighting on Wednesday?
I'm finding a guy named Micah Graff. He's been sitting on my belt for about a year now.
Oh, I like the way you said that.
I've been trying to get down to his weight for a while, but he's been sitting on it for, I think, about a year. I think he won it last April, and now he's fighting in March, so it's 11 months later.
So
when you say your belt, you already held this belt.
No, it's going to be mine.
Earlier.
He's keeping it warm for me.
Well, nice. I brought some tickets that you can give away to your guys' fans.
Oh, my God.
For the fights on Wednesday. So there are four tickets.
Oh, now you fuckers have to pay attention.
Yep. So there's four tickets.
Four of us are going to be going to the fights.
That's not the way it works. I will watch your Facebook to make sure they're given away.
Wait. I want you to say that again. You're going to be what?
Watching your Facebook page.
Watching our Facebook.
See, Sarah.
That's where
Sarah,
they're going to be.
Watching BreakFace.
Hey, I watched your guys' podcast, and I was like, okay, I guess I can go on with these guys. Yeah. At the second podcast, I was like, I don't know. And then I watched Jeff's, and I said, okay, we can do this.
We are crazy, and we don't have a format, which I think makes this, you know, it's more legit to me. If we go in going, okay, we have a segment, it's not going to work.
Yeah.
But you know what? One thing.
When we have guests on, we respect our guests, and we want our fans, you know, are
there's
want
not,
them to see what we see and do what we do. So
there's not a niche in Alaska, at least like this, for fighters or for the
AFC. My God, you look like a fucking animal.
I have a trading card. No big deal.
Oh, is
my boy has a trading card.
It's okay, but that
full disclosure, I've known Tommy.
It's a trading card, but it's also a senior schedule.
Longer than 20 years.
This is my boy.
Oh, look at you. When was this taken? This morning with your shirt off.
Oh no, I look much better than that now.
That's funny.
Oh. You shouldn't have said that. It's upside four down. I'm sorry. Yeah. I see what you're doing.
Yeah, four of these here. Giveaway at BreakFace from.
Now turn it upside down so you can see Tommy.
Okay, there's Tommy.
Yeah.
So four tickets for all the AFC/BreakFace fans.
Yep.
That's awesome. That's badass. Thank you, Sarah.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. We're going to have to do some giveaways.
And I'll tag on our Facebook page because, you know, we got a few. So.
I'm sorry. We small potatoes.
Hey,
how you doing?
I'll help you. Hey, I run all the social media accounts myself too. Except my daughter does work on the Instagram page. I pay her to get likes. So she.
Whoa! Oh, yeah. I dig that. So that's what we got to do. We got to pay somebody.
Yep.
I have a 14-year-old daughter.
I started her, know Instagram. So I started her at a quarter a follower that she gets paid every week. On how many followers she gets, and now I give her a raise because she hit like 150 followers.
You can do a penny a follower.
So like,
I could do a quarter.
Are you hiring?
No, I'm not hiring.
You get some followers.
50 cents. Now she's up to 50 cents a follower.
Wow, really?
Whoa.
She got a raise.
But you've also raised the game. It's like you found these followers. Now you got to dig deeper.
Yeah,
and find
exactly.
More.
Yeah, she pulled my Instagram. I think from about 900, she's up to about 1200.
So she's handling all your social media accounts.
No, she's not. Only Instagram. No?
Okay.
I do well. Now we have all of them. You know, I have a Facebook, so AFC Sarah Facebook, and then Snapchat AFC Sarah, and then Instagram AFC Sarah. But then we have Alaska
Twitter?
Fighting. Oh yeah, Twitter, AFC Sarah. But
not a fan of Twitter?
No, the Twitter
you don't tweet much?
No, I do.
We have a Twitter account.
It's at like Alaska Fighting, so
we don't understand it.
Well,
you need a big base, otherwise it's kind of pointless. You're tweeting 140 characters or less to some like three people.
But you know what? You can massive shit talk when the fights are going on. It's so much fun. Like oh. I just, yeah, I talk so much crap
you
to fighters.
Can because I, and I'm going to add you to our friend list. But other than that, no, everybody's like, who the fuck is
no,
that?
No, all you have to what? Do is at
He's
them.
Shit talking me.
Yeah, it's Dana White. You
can oh, you can
oh,
add
oh, no,
anybody.
I see what you're saying.
Joe Rogan yeah. or anybody.
I see what you're saying.
Yeah, so you'd be like, okay. at Joe Rogan, check out my podcast.
Faggot.
I'm just kidding. I love Joe Rogan.
We all love Joe Rogan, oh, but I'm shoot. Sure that
but
would
call him out. You see, okay. that'll work.
Yeah. Come on, you fucking homo.
Yeah,
just tweet it. Stop sucking dicks and get yeah. my podcast.
Yeah. No, he's.
You're
he's,
never allowed on again.
Sorry, sir.
You're done. She's coming by herself.
No, he's coming back. Yeah. You're
we'll see what.
But yeah,
what
you can tweet people
once I start. One of the few belts my way down to one.
I have a feeling that you're going to be on very soon, showing us your belt.
Yeah,
I do.
Definitely.
And Sarah's going to allow this.
You can do what he does what he wants. He's on his own.
Oh, he
that
does what
true.
He,
I'm an adult.
I do.
I'm an adult. I can do what I want.
I would like.
Let's tell him about all the adult situations that you put me in, Tommy.
Oh, man. No comment?
Yeah. That's
it would be really
It was
nice.
One really bad situation, but.
I can think of two, but you know what? These are. They're, oh, wait. It's funny because I'm like the mama bear, and
I can think of two also.
Yeah, I yeah. I get some really, really weird phone calls at weird times and all sorts of stuff.
Tommy, what are you doing at night?
Huh? Can we hear one from Tommy's perspective? Can we hear
Tommy's
one of
like,
his stories?
Sarah,
no comment.
Sarah. Oh. No comment. I'll just, I actually, this one's clean. This one's
I'm stuck underneath
clean.
A 400 hooker.
No, there's
400 pound hooker.
Hey, that might have happened. Okay, so with Tommy, you never know.
What do I do? What do I do? So, chew your way out, fucker. Chew your way out.
What happens in Vegas? What happens in Vegas?
Yeah, I have not been to Vegas
with
Tommy.
Broccoli.
So.
I'm about to not make weight.
No, yeah. No, so.
There's no prosciutto in this whore.
What do I do?
Oh, jeez Louise. So, the one time.
But there
this,
is cheese.
Jeez Louise.
Stop.
Cheese, cottage cheese.
I got to chew my way through the cottage cheese.
Okay.
I love the dimples in her
stomach. Oh, my God.
How did we get here?
It's your fault.
Definitely not. That's
you started this.
No.
It's me.
I'm talking about Tommy.
I take blame. Okay.
No, so in Wasilla, do you remember the Wasilla incident?
Yo, check it out.
Go on.
Okay, so there was fights out there, and Tommy likes to definitely antagonize just anything in general. He's a pretty good... Tommy, I just thought of another one, the one in Soldotna.
That's the one I thought you were going to tell me about.
That's three, bro. That's three.
Yeah.
She said only two.
Yeah,
what's
but
on?
The well, the first...
That one
the,
was bad.
Yeah, the one... Yeah, that
telling
one,
you, this is my boy.
Okay.
Trifecta, motherfucker.
So the one in Wasilla, Tommy decides to get into it with this guy who's like 6'5", huge, and somehow I end up in the middle.
Was
and
he
I'm,
drunk?
I think he had a couple cocktails, but I jumped in between.
Wait, the guy he's fighting or him?
Both.
Okay.
So I jumped in between both of them, and Tommy, I mean, this guy is towering
over
me.
This guy started it, not
no,
me.
No, you called him a faggot.
I don't even know who started it, okay. But I did jump in the middle of it to save the life of Tommy Ide, and Tommy's over my shoulder.
Save life that guy.
Tommy's over my shoulder, just like a freaking bulldog. Oh, yeah? Fuck you. What are you going to do, man?
This was like
what are you going to do? And
eight,
he's like
10 years ago.
Yeah,
so.
This is like a long time ago. But he's over my shoulder screaming at this guy, and the guy is just getting mad and mad. And I'm like, whoa, it's okay. I'm like, Tommy, shut the fuck up.
You should have let him go.
And said. No,
it's your ankles,
death?
Bro.
No, that the one in Soldano was pretty good though. Tommy actually, that kid,
I think I deserved to get beat, and I didn't do anything. So
no, the guy didn't get beat up.
That's what I said.
Yeah, why not?
No, but Tommy, the guy goes.
Are you a lover? You ain't a fighter.
No, Tommy's
like
broke things
the
up
ring.
Multiple times.
So
but there's lots
there's
of good stories.
There's one thing that is a trigger for me, and that's any of my friends or myself being.
Yep.
Oh yeah. Good.
Disrespected at all, and I won't.
Yeah,
I'll do my best to explain to them that it's not in their best interest or ours for them to continue.
Wow.
Yeah.
So are we friends
if
now?
If they cross any points, oh, absolutely.
So can we go to the bar
basically
and I can talk
give
shit?
Fuck
and just
no. Like, oh.
Honestly,
no. Fight?
Well, here's the deal.
It doesn't work like that.
Most fighters friend. Do not get in. I mean, people are always worried, oh, go to the after fight party. You got a bunch of fighters that are going to beat up a bunch of people. No, fighters do not fight, typically. Yeah. I mean, there's definitely guys that are hotheads and it happens, but they don't fight in the bar.
Especially when they're doing it as a career. It's like...
To defend myself, I will go to very far lengths to defend myself and family and friends.
Right.
And that's generally the incidents that I get into are me defending myself or a friend
right,
that I care dearly about.
Because, dude, I've known you for years. I've never... seen you just go out and just pick a fight with someone.
No.
You don't go out. Hey, I'm Tommy Ed. Well, are you doing? I'm Bobby Ozen.
Now, can I ask you a question, Tommy? Has there ever been a point in time when you're inside a bar drinking and someone tries to pick a fight with you?
Because they know you're a fighter. All the time. Yeah, so it's up to the fighter to control themselves.
Right.
I mean, there's always something to prove. And with Tommy, Tommy's a smaller guy. I mean, you know, he's 5'6".
I don't have the exact stature of a fighter either.
And so it happens a lot. Like, oh, yeah, you think you're tough. And people hate Tommy. They do. They hate Tommy. I get
people
hate
love
mail.
Me.
Well,
I think there's a,
people love him that. Or hate him. He's,
people do love you, but yeah, yes. There's going to be haters.
There's a hate. Hate yeah. I mean, I, hate. I got a
potato's going to potato.
I got a guy that I mean, you know him. You know the situation, and I got a guy that contacted me and just wants to continually fight him. I mean, went on for days. I hate him. I want to beat him up. This guy's a 45er. And he wants to fight him.
Just
why,
let it happen.
Why does he hates give him. You a specific reason?
Oh, he has a personal whatever vendetta, but it doesn't even so, matter. This okay, isn't well, the field to, yeah. to wait, resolve no, those wait, issues. Wait.
You just touched on right. personal. Vendetta.
So what was the personal?
Do you know who she's talking about?
Yeah, I'm not even going to really entertain the idea.
Okay, good. Yeah. We're not going to advertise that fucking douchebag.
Yeah. I mean, there's no reason because it doesn't even make sense. So if a guy calls me up and says,
I do have this question.
Go ahead.
Was there an altercation between you two in the past that he is...
No.
Well,
no.
Fuck him.
Yeah.
No.
Screw it.
No. It's like a he said she said.
I'll tell you
whatever.
Off the air.
High school.
I'll
yeah.
Tell you
high school.
Okay. It's okay. A, and it's
high school bullshit.
It's off
the record, and I'm gonna get your name and your
now,
address.
We are kind of like rounding, like we're at the hour actually. To be honest with you, do you mind? Yeah. You want to keep going? I don't really care. I love this conversation. This is great. But before we do, I really have to talk about one other person.
Yeah.
Lauren Murphy.
Yeah.
That last fight was amazing.
It was
awesome.
Now she's in a video game. which is
I didn't know
that.
She's a video game character.
UFC.
It comes out on the 15th.
Yeah, UFC 2. I'm buying it.
Just to play Lauren.
Yep. Just
and I'm gonna play Lauren and Liz Carmouche, and I'm gonna make the fight go how it should have went the first time.
I'm gonna
can
do
you
that
make
thing
Lauren
where you make
beat the fuck out of Conor McGregor.
I'm gonna yes, make I'm gonna do that
make
thing.
Whatever match you want.
I'm gonna do that thing where you can put the character.
You are
in the,
kidding, right?
Listen, to, no,
oh,
I'm not.
Right.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do that thing where you put the character.
I'm so proud.
Will you
right
shut
now.
The hell up?
No, dude. I'm sorry.
He's like
it's a shock.
Wait a second.
Hey, Lauren, you made it. You are a video game character,
dude. Guys, I remember Lauren before fighting was even a thing in her head.
Guys all over the world are going to be putting Lauren in the corner where the camera is just angled just right.
Don't
just
ever say corner and do that again. That's just fucking weird.
You know what I mean? Where you put the, you know, back in the day when you put Laura Croft because she had the big bazooms, they were triangles, but you put her in the corner and you could kind of.
Yeah, I definitely missed that.
And I'll take snapshots of it and send it to Lauren.
Don't
great, Lauren. He's going to get a full 360 on you.
Lauren, I love you. So hot. Oh my gosh!
You told me to shut up for that.
Those cornrows. I'm sorry.
You're just cornrows.
A bad dude.
I'm just glad I could see her at different angles, other than this and this. Oh wait.
Yeah, she should have won that Liz Carmouche fight. That was bullshit.
Yeah, that was dude. The call was horrible. No, yeah. This last one though, she was like beating the shit out of her, hitting her in the head.
And she goes like this at the referee.
She looks up like, are you going to stop it? And then he's like,
oh yeah.
Oh, I guess I'll stop
it. I'm so glad he did.
We talked about that.
I was waiting for the 20th punch. Come on.
Yeah, that's a classic fighter. 19. Hey, I'm beating this bitch senseless. Do you want me to stop?
Did you guys watch the Bisping Silva fight on Fight Pass?
No, I missed it. I missed it.
Wait, why? Can I ask you why? When they announced her, they didn't say fighting out of Alaska because where her gym is at.
Yeah, she's training at the lab with Ben Henderson.
Okay.
So she claims. Did you see what she did at the end?
No,
because she said 9. Oh,
oh, did she?
7. Oh, yeah.
I didn't see
well,
that.
Well, go to.
I wouldn't fight
at
that.
AFC Sarah's Instagram, hold on. And you will here. See it there.
I'm gonna have. Well, I it's can't
on
do that
her,
right now.
Her Facebook.
There you go, Lauren Murphy Facebook.
As a video game.
They look at her.
That's her video game character.
Yep, and her tattoos are like legit.
Dude, they are. That's totally awesome. So, do you know why they picked her? Was it why?
Lauren, because she's a badass.
No, I know because she's a badass.
15 bantamweights in the world.
Yeah.
Okay.
The entire world.
Yep. In the world,
she was ranked top 15 before she ever hit the UFC ever.
Yeah,
that is amazeballs.
I mean, she was the Invicta champion. I mean, she beat
the girl
Nakamura
that was supposed
Nakamura
to be the best
in the
world
the,
ever.
Yeah.
So it's pretty awesome, and she's Lauren's had a couple tough fights, but she's supposed to be fighting that girl that she was supposed to be, Sarah Moraes or whatever. She's supposed to be fighting. She's been calling around Twitter. If you guys are on there, you could check it out. They talk a lot of shit.
Didn't listen to her. If you guys actually use your Twitter account, I get on there and I look at all this stuff. And I'm like, meh, skip. Next,
I get on it when the fights are going on, and I'll tweet. You know, fight. It's fun because you can talk shit and you know whatever.
A lot of times they'll respond to you too. like.
Oh, really?
Personally. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like retweets fighters? And fighters. Oh, yeah, yeah, that's how you build your following is like you get on there and tweet.
One
we need to stop talking about social media because we already sound like retards.
We're social media inept, apparently.
Not that there's anything.
How old are you guys?
We're old enough to not know.
Yeah. I'm probably older than you, so.
That's bullcrap.
I doubt it.
What year did you graduate?
I didn't. Thanks for bringing it up.
Yeah. What year were you supposed to graduate?
What year would you
I don't
have
know.
Graduated?
I didn't graduate because I'm stupid.
I can't count that high.
What year would you have graduated, you tard?
I don't know. I can't even remember.
You fucking what year were you born?
You're too stupid to know when you graduated.
What year were you born?
That is so loud in my ear hole.
I know, dude. That's why I'm glad for the beanie.
The beanie.
Yeah, but we're peaking back there. Look at that thing. Boom.
We'll tone it down.
Okay.
Post-production.
Okay, so can I...
Wait. I'm just waiting for her.
2004.
No, shut up. I just wanted to say the age.
What's your age?
No, I want you to say.
Okay, no.
I'm like a woman.
If I guess, will you tell me?
I'm 40.
No, you're not.
No,
40,
don't.
Crap.
You can guess 43. Mine, and if
no,
you guess
not.
Right, I'll tell you.
No, you're not.
Tommy, don't give her any hints, bro. Don't give her any hints, because Tommy probably knows close
she's
to...
She said my own wife traded is a trader.
Yeah, she's like, no, he's not. Okay, right. I'm going to say 31.
I love you. You shot so low on purpose.
No, 34?
No, higher.
38?
Thank you. No, no.
43?
36?
Yes.
36.
No,
fucking 36, gray all day.
36.
36.
Okay.
Wait, can I all guess right. your age?
You can guess.
22.
She's not going to tell.
What are you talking about?
I have a 14-year-old. That would be weird.
Oh, wait, that would be fucking weird.
That would be weird.
You
I
don't
was
even 14 produce eggs.
Whoa.
Negative two.
A woman,
don't egg so. It. Don't do. Don't
I'm
egg
33, it. Almost 34.
That's
wow,
very
you're
honest
young.
Of you. Okay,
you're young.
You're going to guess me now? Tommy.
Wait, can I guess Tommy?
38.
12.
Close.
With a
36.
Beard. No.
Close.
No, I'd have
34.
For real?
34. I don't know. You guys make it sound like you're older.
34? No, you just fucked me up, though. You went 38? That was your first guess?
Okay.
What the fuck?
I don't know.
You said you were old, man. Come on.
I am, but normally when I tell me how old you think I am, I get like really low numbers. Wait, you shot 38.
You said old.
Holy shit.
When he shaves his mustache and beard, he looks like a fetus.
Okay, so 38 is conservative because I don't even think that's technically old because I'm close to that. So
no,
I
just said you're 32.
I'm 33.
Or 33. That's not even close to 30. That's 5 years away.
That's close.
That's like
it was way too accurate. Let's put it that way.
Oh, yo, you're 38?
No, I'm fucking 39. I'm going to be 40 in less than a month.
Oh, see, okay, shut the hell up.
But no,
I caught it right on.
Yeah, but you shot, the shit out of me because most people.
That was fucking close, so I don't even want
to hear it. Crystal, you're fucking clapping. Most people don't even, they go like, I don't know, 30, 29. And I'm like, yeah. And you just went 38. I'm like,
I have to. I could
deflated my
leg.
I was ready to go like this, saying there was no this.
I could do fool the guesser on weights and ages because that's what I do for a living. I look at guys and I like size them up. I'm like, okay. I'm like,
what's my weight?
Okay.
230.
Nope.
Around 230.
Nope.
Yeah, 233.
No, he's not. He's about 245.
233.
Holy damn. It's the hoodie. Okay, can I do it?
What are you?
Wait, you want me to take my shirt off?
No, what's just tell me how much you weigh.
I don't know. It's like 230. 230.
Can I go?
Very close. Yeah.
Okay, my turn.
He said it earlier, so I knew that. Sorry.
How tall are you?
5'8".
He's 350 pounds.
220.
Damn, that's close. 225? Damn. Damn.
What did he say?
But I'm 6'2".
Oh, you want me? Okay.
Oh, yeah.
How tall are you? 6'2", 6'3"? 6'5"?
Bullshit.
6'.
Oh, 6 foot. Okay.
No, you're not 6 foot. You're shorter than me.
He weighs like
170. 185.
196.
She is good.
Dude, she works with fighters, bro.
Yeah, but he has his clothes
Gabby,
on.
Gabby, stand up. No, I'm just kidding.
No.
On a good day, when she's fighting, she's 125.
Can we?
115.
We do.
I know that. She fought at 125.
Guess my son-in-law. Yeah. Guess my son-in-law.
Oh, shit.
Matt, stand up.
Sit up.
No, man. I don't. See, I don't have guys that fight this big. So,
I'm going to go with a solid 195.
Let's see. Give me a 360 here. Let's see.
Show her your bare ass.
Do not do that. No.
Okay.
Right, no.
How tall are you?
You're the one that made the rule and you're telling him to do it.
No, he's not close
to 6.
Okay,
322. 312. See, I'm not even close.
See, and he shows us his ass and balls like every episode.
Oh, does that really happen?
Actually, it does. You thought it was a joke.
No.
Oh, then we need to put him in the bikini.
Yeah, totally. Yes.
I agree with that.
For Poi Poi's next birthday, we definitely need to get him a lap dance from this dude. It's going to have to be
blindfold him, though.
A much bigger chair.
We'll go to the bench.
A stable.
What, the back of one of our trucks, I think, might work. He's going to be like, hey, man, I'm here for my table dance. The truck's going to go like, oh, shit.
That's messed up, man. He's almost blood, man. He's damn close to blood.
That boy, he is blood. That's my
that
son right there.
That dude's going to be all up on
Did
your,
you say son-in-law?
On your daughter.
He is my son-in-law.
That's why I thought you were so old, because to have a son-in-law, you have to have a kid that's old enough
Plus,
to be married.
A son-in-law that looks more like a man than we do.
I have two grandbabies.
You're a grandpa?
Oh, my God. It's crazy, right?
Yeah.
At 29.
No, you shut up.
38.
No, my dad, when I told... I'm
39. I'll be 40 in a month.
I was 18 when I had my daughter, and my dad was like, why are you making me a grandpa so soon? Oh. But he loves it.
Well, yeah, bitch, I'm going to be a mom.
Tell me about it.
He loves it. Cry me a river. He's the only... Or she's the only grandkid so far. I'm waiting on my gypsy sister to get...
Gypsy sister? She's a traveler?
My sister is single, and she is so awesome.
Tommy.
And she's 26 years old. No.
There you go.
Oh. She's 26 years old.
Whoa. She shot Tommy down like a much good Tommy. Ah!
No. Jennifer would whoop his ass.
I'm sorry.
Look
how red his face is right now.
Tommy, your veins are popping.
You want Tommy's pretty
it's
much...
It's the steroids.
No.
It's the steroids. Shut up.
So do you we need test? To do we what?
Do you test?
Test what?
Do they test fighters?
Steroids? No.
They
no, don't?
We're not commissioned in Alaska yet, but
we're working
on
I'm gonna
on
start
that.
Fighting. I'm gonna be all freaking jacked
yeah,
up.
Yeah, you won't win.
I know.
Yeah.
He's gonna take prednisone and gain like 50 pounds.
Of course.
Like, what the fuck, man? Water weight, baby.
That's the worst. That's you know and I know. That's
Did you just say prednisone?
Prednisone.
I know what prednisone is. It don't make you strong.
No. It's steroids, though.
It's Yeah.
It's a different kind of steroid.
Hold up.
Prednisone doesn't
this is
do that.
This is one of those you know moments where the star shoots on the screen.
The more you know.
Now you know.
It's a steroid, but it doesn't do the same thing.
No.
It's
definitely not.
It's
not an anabolic.
Anti-inflammation.
That's what MS patients take.
That's why I'm clapping right now, because, wow, you're not as dumb as
lupus,
I thought you were.
Lupus, MS, it's a normal treatment.
About? I've been shooting up steroids for the past I don't know how many years. I got to do it because I'm low testosterone. I got bitch tits. What?
Well,
whatever, TRT.
I noticed you're like AFC.
Capital A to capital C.
Rock, paper, scissors, motherfucker.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, for winning
you're never going to
look. I'll take it.
Yeah,
take
I take it too. That's way better than
it.
A beanie.
Yeah. Dude, it's way better than.
Rocks.
Boom.
That's hilarious.
That's okay. That's payback for what did I do last week? A fat M&M.
Oh yeah, you call me a fucking. I'm a fat version of M&M.
M&M. I thought you meant like the ones you eat,
like Marshall Mathers.
No, no.
You're kind of looking like a green M&M today.
Marshall Mathers. Oh
no! Hold on. I told him if he shaved his facial hair, he'd look like a fat M&M.
Green one's a girl.
He didn't like that.
I forgot.
Where's your eyelashes?
Oh jeez.
He knew. Oh, and I got the tit grab.
I was just at M&M World in Vegas. Oh, yeah.
I didn't get a tit grab.
I tried.
Not appropriate.
I tried. Hey, you bring your husband with you, and then he can give you okay.
No, I don't need okay. My husband lets me...
Oh, let you grab all
he
the tits.
He lets anyone grab my tits that I want to grab
pretty
my
much.
Tits.
No. I mean, you have to imagine being my husband and dealing... I mean, I deal with
dealing
fighters.
With
no, well, oh. Yeah, and dealing with me, too. He definitely... dealing with me
task,
is a
I'm
task
sure.
in itself, but...
I would attest to that.
He is super supportive and amazing and awesome.
When is... Bob gonna step down and let me take over the announcements?
Never.
Bull crap.
I think as soon as you get over
fighting out of the red corner. Oh shit!
You got to get over there.
Oh my god! There's beer everywhere.
That was almost DEFCON 1.
That's it. No more pot for me. Ever. Never.
So back to my sister. Okay, we're looking. 26 years old. She's cute. She's single and she needs a date.
How old is she?
I'll talk to my wife and see what we can work out.
How old did you say?
26. She's hot.
I know,
she can fight.
I don't know anybody that young.
AFC Sarah, everyone. Pimping out her 26-year-old sister.
She doesn't have to. Listen. Hey, you know what?
For dates, guys.
She,
calm down.
She would hate. She's gonna see this. And
it's
I can't
a good thing
wait.
We only have like 5 viewers.
No, we're gonna have a. I'm gonna be sharing this.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
No, but my. I want like nieces and nephews and stuff. It's time. So long term commitment. This is just not.
And it's
you
just
know,
you and her. There's no brothers. There's
yeah.
No...
My brother. He is 20. Okay. He's turning 20.
Is he taken?
No.
So no. he could provide. Oh.
Not really. I mean,
so I could hook up with your brother and we could adopt.
Definitely not. He doesn't swing for the other team.
No, my brother is like he's kicked back. Like he's not.
Or the same team. that's what I meant.
Yeah, my brother likes playing video games. You guys are fucking crazy.
Yeah, they're fucking crazy. Oh, my lungs.
Hey, girl, you said you watched the podcast before you came on.
Yeah, I did.
It's never been this fun. And yeah. This is the problem with other podcasts is nobody's ever this fun. These are freaking fun.
Who's the Bills fan?
That's me. Oh, I'm the Bills
fan. I'm sorry, man.
Oh, don't be like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, me too.
I'm a Cowboys fan.
You're
so.
Bills fans?
Well,
no, I'm a Seahawks fan. And my husband is a Patriots fan, so last year's Super Bowl was not good at my house.
Yeah, but not.
92-93.
My husband went to UMass Amherst, so he's, you know, he was a beer boy at the Pat Stadium.
Is this only because you're in Alaska and that's the closest team and that's who?
I was born there.
Oh, well, there you go.
Wait, what?
She was born in Seattle.
I was born outside Seattle, hour and a half north of Seattle. So well, there you go. Seahawks and Mariners are my team. And I'll root for the Pats and the Red Sox if they're not playing my team.
You and my dad would get along great.
Did you say Pats?
Yeah, my husband's went to UMass Amherst. So he was...
Like Patriots Pats?
He had ass hammers?
New England Patriots Pats?
Yeah.
What are ass hammers?
Ass hammers. UMass Amherst. That's where he went to college. So he spent a lot of ass hammers. I don't know. That would be interesting. Mm.
That's disgusting, you guys. Well, let's pull together. Come on.
Okay,
pull it together.
Right. Hey, so. I just want to say thank you very much for
Thanks
coming
for having
on.
Us.
You guys have been fucking fantastic. Poypoy won a hoodie. I got this fucking bomb dope-ass hat.
You guys are going to win some bomb.
I got to hang out with a good friend of mine that I haven't seen in fucking ever, Tommy.
Too long, for sure.
Potbelly Assassin. He was going to get a fucking belt next week.
And we want you guys to at least plug what you can do.
And like, that is exactly it. I want you guys, you know, tell us everything.
Pretty much plugged everything already.
Okay.
And, yeah, we're good.
Do you? How about a recap in 2 seconds? Go.
A recap in 2 seconds? Go. 2 seconds. Follow me at AFC Sarah. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, whatever. Quick. At Alaska Fighting for Alaska Fighting.
Whoa.
That's so fast. I said 2 seconds.
Okay, you. Go. Quick.
AK Potbelly at pretty much every type of social media.
I would
name my sponsors, but I have like 20 of them, and it would be a tough time.
Well, can you name a couple?
Yeah, name a couple.
Some of your big ones.
Soundworks, Color Me Tan.
But you're not tan. Sorry.
Oh, man. He's been tanning.
What's up?
He's been tanning.
Yeah, okay, you're darker than me. All okay, right. Sorry, go ahead. Sorry.
Moving on. Big Dipper Clothing. I feel bad because I can't remember him right now.
It's okay.
No,
man.
Back your shirt. Oh, yeah. Gabby's shirt on.
Yeah, it's
okay.
And not on my new shirts.
That's right.
I brought you guys some stickers, too, because
MS Society of Alaska.
Yeah. Alaska MS Center. Buy a shirt from Tommy. We're going to have some extras. Buy some tickets from Tommy for the upcoming fight this Wednesday. The beanies, like I said, we only have 20 of them. They're $20.
Put that on Tommy.
Yeah, put it on your head. There you go.
And we have a few extra of the shirts, the orange shirts.
And they're hipster beanies. No big deal.
Yep. They're hipster beanies. They're cool.
About
proceeds are getting donated to Alaska MS Center.
Good fucking cost.
So Alaska MS Center is getting all the proceeds for the yellow orange hats and
the t-shirts
as well.
Yep. And any tickets that Tommy sells.
Yeah.
And look, Potbelly just bought his own.
He's buying them. Shut up, brother.
That's awesome.
Did you just buy me a hoodie?
I'm sorry, a beanie.
A fucking beanie.
All right, so Potbelly just kicked in.
Oh, my God, dude.
$40. So, and there's one save for Paul, so I only leave 7 left.
Here, I'm going to buy two more for my wife's.
Look at this, guys.
You see wives?
I got two wives.
Your wives?
I'm polygamy.
He doesn't have two wives. All right,
guys, so they just about wiped us out. So you better get a hold of us and buy the others. Yeah, they're almost gone.
Awesome. Hey, I want you guys to follow us on Facebook. Of course, if you guys are listening to this, you probably already know that. And YouTube. And just...
Twitter. Follow them on Twitter.
Follow us on
Twitter. They need Twitter followers. Right? They're desperate.
Follow us on Twitter.
And try to follow us. We're going to lose
Twitter
you.
Followers.
I don't know what else we got. We do have one.
We want to say also thank you to our sponsor, Alaska Josh Audio Moss. Works. Josh Moss.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, my brother. And wow, it's been great having you guys on, and I can't fucking wait to have you on again.
I'd love to be on the next show with my belt, guys. So.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Let you guys know what's up.
And I have a little surprise for you guys. I have 4 tickets cage side for you guys for this upcoming fight on Wednesday.
Cage side. That's cage side of the ring.
Wait, what did you just say?
Like 3 feet of the ring.
Wait, what did you just say?
Yeah, or you could just take these journal missions back if you want those.
No.
Okay, so no. I have. No. So you guys have to bring your wives and you're going to come cage side.
Okay. Like within 5 feet of me beating some dude. Fuck up.
Hell yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Nope. You're awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Oh my God. Up here.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
You're going to have to get the general mission. Okay. Sorry.
So what we do at the end of every episode is we go, it's like a rock, paper, scissors. We go 1, 2, 3, and break face.
But we lean back. You got to lean back.
See, she's seen it.
Yeah.
One, two, three. Break face!
Peace out, crackers.
Love you, motherfuckers.
And that's it.
That was awesome, guys.
My camera took a shit.
That's